And so thank God that she has found Jesus. And thank God in finding Jesus that she has made up her mind that she will stand for righteousness, that she'll stand in the gap and make up the hedge. Today is the day. Where is the church? Where is the church of the living God? Where are those who take the name of Christ? Where are those who have chosen to say that, you know what, that I'm going to put my faith and trust in Jesus? Stand up and be counted. Stand for righteousness. Stand for holiness. Stand for the Word of God. Stand in the gap for those who are being led to the slaughter. Stand in the gap for those who are given over to a strong delusion. Awaken their conscience. Be a voice. Speak thus saith the Word of the Lord. Do not be weary in well-doing, for in due season ye shall reap if ye faint not. Let's hear it for Kim. Let's hear it for Kim. Thank God for a righteous woman. Thank God for a righteous woman. Now what we need to do is this, is pray for righteous lawmakers. We need to pray for the righteous politicians. We need to pray for every individual to do that which is right in the eyes of God.
There is a way that seems right to a man, but the end thereof is death. Homosexuality seems right to people who've abandoned God, but the end thereof is death. Not only physical death, but spiritual death. Folks, we invite you to humble your hearts and trust God today. Folks, Jesus says, come unto me, all ye that labor, salvation, they're heavy laden, you'll find rest for your souls. There's rest in Jesus. There's rest and mercy in Jesus. There's no rest. There's no mercy in perversion. There's no rest. There's no mercy in adultery, in immorality, in pornography. There's no rest in that. Come and humble your hearts today and trust God. Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. Folks, your religious traditions, your pride, your homosexuality, none of that is good before God. It's all filthy rags. Come and repent. Humble your heart and trust God. Weep for your nation. Weep for the souls of the lost. Weep over sin and cry to God. Folks, this is a spiritual battle. This is a spiritual battle between heaven and hell, between Jesus Christ and his righteousness, and the life of the devil, the people that he's enslaved. Who will humble their heart? Who will trust God? Who will seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness? What shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? Folks, an emotion does not win. A feeling does not win. God wins. God is the judge. God is the determiner of what is right and wrong. God is the determiner of what is truth and what is error. God says today, you shall know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Friends, you can continue in sin, continue in lust, continue in lies. You will not be free. You will be judged. You will be condemned by Almighty God. I'm not the judge of your soul. I am your neighbor calling out that your behavior is bringing you into the judgment of God. The lies you're telling, the lies you're living are bringing you into the judgment of God. Folks, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Folks, you don't love God if you don't love his commands. Folks, you don't love God. You reject his standard. You reject his word and you go by your feelings. Your feelings will deceive you. All of our feelings are subject to deception and change. And I've got great news for you, the best news you've ever heard in your life. The Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we pray for Kim Davis right now in Jesus' name. We pray that she would boldly stand for Jesus Christ. We pray that she would boldly deny this unlawful, illegal court opinion. We pray that she would deny this wickedness and turn and continue to stand for her conscience. Would repent of their complicity with perversion. We pray that the lesser magistrates of Kentucky would stand for righteousness and would humble themselves and say, Lord Jesus, we want your blessings on our state, not more federal money. We want to honor the Lord Jesus Christ, not a corrupt, evil president. Lord Jesus, we pray right now that you would turn these out of the way. We pray, Lord God, that you turn this city, this state, this nation away from that rebellion. Turn them to the mercy and love of God. Turn them to the righteousness of God. Turn them to faith in Jesus Christ again. Lord, you searched your word says you searched for men who would stand in the gap against evil. Well, you couldn't find many. You couldn't find any elected officials in Kentucky who would stand for Jesus, but you found King David. Lord, we bless him in Jesus' name. We thank you that you saved her from sin, death, and hell. We thank you that it's really not about her. It's about who is Lord. Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus Christ is Lord. The Supreme Court of the United States, the United States government, no man, no government is Lord. Jesus Christ is Lord, and every knee will bow, every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Confess it in humble contrition today. Confess it in brokenheartedness today. Will there still time? Will there still mercy? Turn to the living God today. Will your sins can be forgiven? Turn to the living God today before his judgment and wrath are poured out. In Jesus' name, amen.